Hello students, how are you? So let's start with six signs. Let's begin. We will continue this chapter number 5 of standard 6 science, separation of substances. In the previous video, you have seen different methods of separation. We have seen winnowing method, hand picking, threshing. We have seen different methods of separation, sedimentation, decantation, filtration and loading method. Now, in this video, we are going to see another method of separation. So, topic whichever we are going to see today are, we will define evaporation, condensation, and we will see separate water and salt by evaporation and condensation method. This is related to your daily life also, so watch carefully. Now, we will see what is evaporation. The changing of a liquid into vapor or gas is called evaporation. Evaporation is used to obtain a solid substance that has dissolved in water or any other liquid. The dissolved substance is left as a solid residue when all the water has evaporated. You can see it in the figure also. Here evaporation takes place and the vapors are going up as the vapors are light. So this is evaporation method. Evaporation is a process in which liquid changes into gaseous form on heating, allowing the liquid to evaporate, leaving the soluble solid behind. So this is evaporation method. Now we will see about condensation. Condensation means the changing of water vapor into liquid. Water on cooling is called condensation. When come in contact with the cold outside surface of glass, they get cooled and condensed to form tiny drops of water. Watching to daily life, if on our specs, if we are blowing, at that time we can see vapors, drops of tiny droplets we can see on the glass of the spectacle. So this is also one example of condensation. Now we shall watch video, so watch carefully children.
If we continuously heat water, it gets converted into vapors. The process of conversion of water into its vapor is called evaporation. Here is a beaker containing salty water. What will happen if we boil such solution for a longer time? You will observe evaporation of water. When whole water gets converted into vapors, you will observe salt at the bottom. The vapors are cooled to form water, which is collected in another beaker. The process of conversion of vapor into water is called condensation. With the help of evaporation and condensation, it is possible to separate components of solution. For this method to work, different components must have different boiling point. Boiling point is a temperature at which liquid substance get converted into vapor form. We use this method to separate salt from seawater. Basically, seawater is captured in shallow pits. The sunlight heats the water and slowly water gets evaporated. After complete evaporation of water, we get salt free from water. It is then further purified to be used in our food as common salt. From Earth's crust, we get crude oil. It is a mixture of various components such as petrol, diesel, kerosene, etc. These components are separated with the help of evaporation and condensation method. Here we complete this topic. For more such videos, visit learnfatafat.com.
So by watching video, I think your concepts are clear now about evaporation, condensation and where we can use this method. Now, this is, you can say summary also and question round also. Summary we will see means what we have seen in this video. We have seen evaporation, what is meant by evaporation, we have seen what is about, we have seen about condensation. Now, After that, we have seen to separate water and salt by evaporation and condensation method. So this is also your homework. Try to find out the answers. Define evaporation, define condensation, and now you have seen the video and you observe that. So you have to write your observation that how you can separate salt and water by evaporation and condensation method. So do homework. Thank you for watching video. Keep watching video again and again for better understanding.